Oh, boy, that's embarrassing. Well, now I have to kill you, I'm sorry. No witnesses. Okay, yeah, I figured the key would just unlock all the doors around here. I mean, I would hope. Not really a heck of a lot out here, though. Okay, the symbol of the king. I'm guessing that's probably referring to a boss. I don't think I'd have anything in my inventory that would apply at the moment. It'd probably be like a ring or something. Like, I don't really know what you could even produce. Like, using a boss soul, like, that wouldn't do anything, I wouldn't think. That sounds like it makes sense, right? Alright. Let's just try something here. Okay. I'm pretty sure I hit it. Like, I'm gonna open it up regardless, but it's just sort of an awkward angle to be throwing it at with this giant item screen in the way. Oh, yeah, that's... sounds pretty helpful. Although I'm sure that it doesn't recover HP, like, super quickly or anything. Otherwise, I'd be kind of a game breaker. But yeah, maybe I'll try it out sometime. Dropping down here doesn't seem like a very good idea, but I think I am actually gonna just have to drop down. Can't do a plunging attack on that guy, unfortunately. Because, like, as far as I know, there's no... Oh, yeah. Yeah, I haven't found a door down here. But yeah, that was fine. Jeez. Okay, well, never mind then. Alright, I think I'm gonna try this side. See if I can't only pull one of them this time. And let's use the Flame Quartz Ring. If there's ever a time to use it, I think this is probably a good one. I think if I can just manage to, like, get behind him... Which is easier said than done. Damn it. Alright. That's okay. Oh god, he's so fast! I do like his little eyes moving around, though. Okay, if this armor doesn't help out any, I might just have to throw in the towel because I can't really, I don't know, this guy is, like, tougher than the last giant was. Seems to be working a little bit, certainly more than just charging right up to him. Okay, yeah, that wasn't too bad, I suppose. Nope, jeez. Rolled right into that first one. Surprised I didn't get scorched. You'll have to forgive me if I'm kind of in the zone here. Ugh, no, come on. I realize this probably isn't the most interesting fight to watch. Oh, come on. But this guy has just been kicking my ass. Ugh. Finally. Oh boy. Well, suffice it to say, I died quite a bit on this guy. I'm not sure how many times at this point, but good gravy. And I think, let's just loot this before the other guy kills me or something. Oh, alright. Oh, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Of course I forget to equip the Flame Quartz Ring. I've been remembering it, like, every other time, but the time that I actually do it, I leave that stupid falling ring on. Doesn't it figure? But I'm wearing robes that help out with fire defense, so that seemed... I mean, even without... Ow, arrows. Okay. But yeah, I mean, even without the Flame Quartz Ring, it seemed to be pretty good fire defense. And I also had flash sweat going, so not only was I just dripping with sweat in the game, I was actually drenched with sweat in real life, just trying to fight this guy. Okay, let's get this guy over with. It really is interesting how much more trouble these guys have been giving me than some of the bosses. Like the Scorpioness? Eh, no problem. I'll beat her on my first try. These guys? Oh no. You joking? Come on. I think if I manage to hit their underbelly, that's like their critical point. It's just a matter of timing it out right. And this guy was like, I don't know, maybe just because I had sort of a handle on them, but seemed not quite as tough that first one. Maybe it's because I'm, like, mostly decked out in all my fire defense gear now. I'm actually wearing my fire ring, so, you'd be proud, Mom. Oh, jeez. Wasn't expecting that. I'd rather not fight this guy down here, though. Oh, no, you're not gonna follow me out? Eh. Because, like, especially if I'm, like, uphill, and plus, like, so close to him, if he starts shooting fireballs, I'm not sure if I'll really be able to avoid them. Although, is he not even... I guess he's not a fireball guy? Is that not a thing we're doing anymore? Because I can certainly get behind that. I am okay with that. And I kind of wish I had unequipped my pun- Oh! That's always something new. This guy's got all kinds of tricks up his sleeve. But yeah, I don't know why I brought my pyromancy stuff down here, aside from, like, flash sweat. But It's fine. I'll use an amber herb if I have to. I keep, like, telling myself that, yeah, I'll just use it during, like, a boss fight or something, and it's never come up, so... Oh, what? Okay, I guess it has some pretty good range on it. If you say so, game, if you're telling me I got burned, well, I won't fight you on it, but it's a little... calling shenanigans just a little bit, I think. Not sure which would be better on these guys, though. Definitely, obviously, not the fire longsword. I guess this one, for the fire reduction. It's a little surprising how steep the difficulty curve just became for this place. Like, hey, you know, let's have him fight the last giant, who's not an especially hard boss. And, yeah, just once they drop down here, like, I don't know, maybe it's because I'm just a shitty wizard, but... boy. Yep, this is not gonna work. Melee is definitely not my strong suit. And, like, I don't want to use up all my herbs on this area. It's really just too bad that Yearn does... Oh, come on. Like, if Yearn affected these guys, this would be so much easier. But I think I'm just... I don't think I'm gonna even bother. Oh, you know what? Yeah, this is that, that first guy I killed who was shooting fireballs at me through the grate. So this is apparently how I get down here. Yeah, I'm not even gonna worry about killing that guy. Well, there's a guy right on the other side. Let's see if this works again. I guess not. Do we actually need a key this time? Well, that sucks. I hear you. Like, do you need help? There's probably a handle you can just... I'm pretty sure it's a pull door. Well, great. I'm glad that this ended up just being a huge waste of time. Okay, yeah. I think there are a couple other doors like this I should be able to unlock. Don't quite recall where they all are, but I suppose I'll just have to do another lap through this place. Great. Oh. Hey, buddy. I don't really feel so bad about killing him, just because... I'm fairly certain he was napping on the job, is the thing. Like, he was supposed to be stalking the storeroom, like, taking inventory and just being a general layabout. So as punishment, I think it's only fitting that I break everything. I just like the idea that someone's gonna walk in to check on him and be like, hey there, Fred, how's it oh god. Someone's cleaning this mess and it's not gonna be me. Oh, nice. And the small white soapstone, I believe, lets me get summoned to other people's sessions, but there's like a time limit or something like that. Or like I'm like a gray phantom or something. Oh. Okay, would have thought there'd be an illusory wall, but I guess not. Oh, mother! Yeah. Eh. I guess that's okay. Oh, you dope. You took too long. You had a perfectly good ambush set up and you lollygagged. What a blockhead. If that had worked, it would have been a real impressive tag team. But, like, I'm just embarrassed for you, honestly. This is... This is more just like a shitty Sen's Fortress than anything. These people are all setting up booby traps and stuff, and it's not working out for you. It's just, there's no shame in admitting it. It's just not your calling. Maybe try poetry or something. He is pissed. Well, I am actually pretty pleased to see this guy again. Which might sound a little weird, but I was kind of panicking that I'd like really screwed it up. Like, this isn't going to be a perfect playthrough by any means, but, like, I was really nervous that, like, I blew my shot at, like, a one-time thing. So, like, it turns out he was just a boss all this time. And I didn't want to, like, keep harping on it, like, oh, is this guy going to show up again? I don't know, because if he didn't, it just... Look like an asshole, basically. Up, and there we go. Sort of fell twice there. Fell to my death and then sunk into the rock a little bit. That's really gotta hurt, I imagine. Let's try this again. And with some better spells this time. Not that flash sweat isn't good in its own right, but this guy doesn't need to see me sweat anymore. He's already wrecked me a couple times. Don't know if Poison Mist is gonna be worth even attempting, since he's moving around so much. I think I got him? Or maybe not. It doesn't look like he's getting hurt. Maybe he's just immune to poison. Oh, I immediately regret this decision. But no, go ahead, break it. God, what a dick cheese. We're all just trying to have a good time here, okay? I wonder if there's, like, an achievement for nailing him with the ballista. I think that'd be worth 50 gamer points. At least. Get near the edge again. Let's not have a repeat of last time. Okay, you know, that's fine. Not like those things are expensive or anything. Can't really get this guy's timing right. Like, he kind of reminds me of a little bit of Old Dragon Slayer, but... I'm reacting a little too quickly. Like, he's coming at you, and then he's just a little more delayed than I'm expecting. Oh boy, I don't know if I got the Estus Flask off, but... I think I, like, just got it in. Already out of flasks. But, on the plus side, I have 35 life gems, so I think I can take a hit or two. Like that, like... Thankfully, I was able to still avoid that, but yeah, I definitely rolled too early that time. Oh, what the hell? That was really weird. Oh, shit. Goddamn. I went to use the fireball and it, like, spun me around. I have no idea what the heck happened there. I would have been pretty pissed if that had gotten me killed. Like, that... Oh, boy. Oh, you gotta be fucking kidding me. I still have the flame ring equipped? God damn it. Anything would have been better than that. Actually, the old sun ring might have been pretty helpful, considering how much damage I was taking. Oh well. He's dead now, and that's all that matters. It is kind of an interesting idea to have a boss just suddenly drop in on you. Like I said, I was really panicking that I'd, like, screwed it up. Like, that first Hades Knight, I think that's what they're called, like the Hades Knight, but... how we both went, like, tumbling over the edge, and I didn't get to loot what he had. Feel kind of shitty about that, but no reloads. And, yeah, I mean, I want to try and do my best. This is a blind playthrough, so it's not as if I can really go back and redo stuff. But I'm really glad that he showed up again. And I guess that is an interesting concept, to have, like, just a boss fight out of nowhere. Although I wonder what would have happened if I had beaten him the first time. If I even could, I mean, I assume so. I thought that was going to be like another crow's nest. Oh, well. Looks like I've been kidnapped. Bird-napped. I hope this eagle isn't going to be upset with me for killing his master or whatever. He came after me! He pursued me! It's in his name! It wasn't my idea. Oh, would you look at that. Well, the eagle let me go, so I guess he wasn't too cross at me. A little bit, it looks like, because he could have put me down a little more gently. Okay. Yeah, somebody had mentioned there was another route to get to the Lost Bastille, and I guess this is it. Just wondering how the heck I get over there. Yeah, boy. Dropping down is probably not a good idea. Do I have to, like, jump over this? I don't think there's any way I can vault over that, so I'm not even gonna try. But maybe... I don't know. Let's just kill this guy. Oh, yowch. Fireball right to the groin. You just know he's gotta be feeling that one. If you could maybe just show me how to get over there, I'd really appreciate it. Because it looks like this is all just blocked off. Do I have to jump it? No. Oh. I didn't even think I'd be able to get up this. It's the one bit of rubble that I can actually climb up. Oh well. Kinda wish I could just boot this guy off the edge. Give him a swift punt. No. Oh. Well, he heard me running away. He didn't quite hear the sword whizzing by his head. So I don't really think he knew just how close he was to death. He really dodged a bullet there. Or, well, I guess a sword. More like... bunch of dogs, okay. Well, no fireballs, but actually, I think... Oh, yeah! Oh, that's so cool. Yeah, I'm never really sure when these things are gonna explode. It's like, I think I've dropped them before and they haven't blown up. Maybe it hit another gunpowder thing. But like, I'm pretty sure I can jump into them and they don't explode. But if I hit them with my sword, then they should. The Covetous Silver Serpent Ring, that sounds familiar. Oh, that's right. Yeah, this was in the last game. There was like a silver one and a gold one, and I don't remember what the gold one does, but... I think you got the silver one in the Tomb of Giants. You got one of them there. Okay. And I got a ring, or a key, rather. Yeah, great. Super helpful. Well, yeah, I might look up what that unlocks, because that is pretty obtuse. Oh, like if it even unlocks that area with those fire salamanders? Maybe. Yeah, I think I might have to check that out. Like, check it out, meaning, like, just look up what the key does. Because, like, I'm gonna try and avoid spoilers, but something like that, I don't really care. So, like, just in case it's something I've missed. Just to save myself a little bit of time. If at all possible. And this is the tower that Luke Teal was in. Damn it, I don't want to blow myself up. I do have that Ring of Life Protection equipped. Oh no. Oh shit. Alright. Don't get stuck. Yeah, you know what? Go, okay. I was gonna say, if I blow up, I blow up. It's not like I'll lose the souls with this ring on, but it didn't even matter in the end.